Hi, I'm Bush Ninja. Welcome to my medicine blanket. Today, in honor of a holiday that was actually a few days ago, but it was raining here, I want to talk about smoking plants. And not just the two plants that everybody knows about, really mostly, that we smoke, which are tobacco and cannabis, but all the different kinds of plants that we can smoke with a reason. And also, not just the oregano that you got sold and smoked, but things that you might actually do so on purpose. And the reasons you might smoke something would generally be the effect it has on your body, whether it's some kind of recreational intoxication kind of effect, or mostly the taste. So, you might do it because it tastes nice, and that's what people enjoy doing, smoking different things that they smoke. Even the things that you smoke, taste is a big component of them. And so, there are these other plants that I like to smoke. I create what I call a Bush Ninja splurfs. And it's not a spliff, it's a splurf, because it's all these herbs mixed in with the spliff. And I combine them together for different reasons. And one of my very favorite plants to talk about is passion flower. Now, this is a fresh passion flower leaf, or passiflora, or grenadilla, or maracuja, another name for it. And it's super anti-anxiety. This one came to me in a time when things were really hectic in my life, and something just told me to put it in my pipe and to smoke it. And it was like a pair of scissors came, cut the rubber bands off my chest. And it had no high associated with it, and it doesn't, but it mixes very well with cannabis and helps cut out any of that anxiety, paranoia stuff. It helps reduce it for me in my body anyways. The other thing I like to smoke, but you'll notice this is very flat and smooth, so just pay attention to the shape. It's almost glossy. Now, another one I like to smoke is called mullein. Now, mullein is so fuzzy, it's almost fluffy in its fuzziness. There's other botanical words, but we don't have to worry about this. But this is a bronchodilator, so I mix this in to help open up my lungs. Now, if you look at the passion flower, it's so flat, and when it's dry, I have some dry here. You crumble it and it turns into like plates. And if you were to roll those, there would be big gaps of air and there would be packed together bits, and doesn't smoke good well in a splurf form. In a pipe, it'll be fine. All these things smoke fine in a pipe mostly. But if you're trying to roll it, if you try to roll up some mullein, it'll burn all crazy because it's so fluffy and all the different things. But if you mix the different things together and the other things that we're going to talk about, the burnability of them, or how they actually physically smoke, is a component to mixing these things together. So that comes with experience, and maybe I'll do more advanced videos on that. But the passion flower, like I said, anti-anxiety. The mullein isn't affecting my attitude or my energy or how I feel. It's just opening up my lungs and helping me feel. It's really nice at the end of a festival and you've been smoking all kinds of things, or you got some kind of lung sickness, or even asthmatics used to smoke this during asthma attacks. I am not recommending that asthmatics smoke anything or anybody do anything, and always keep your inhaler nearby. But before inhalers were invented, it is historically documented that mullein was smoked and made as a tea and as a tincture, and is a good medicine, and it grows all over my country. Another plant that I like to smoke is Damiana. And you notice this one, it's kind of in between. It almost looks a lot like cannabis, frankly, if it's all ground up. And it smokes pretty well just on its own. And you can mix it as an intermediary between the fluffy and the straight smooth, and it really helps carry the ember along. But it's also, they call it an aphrodisiac. And I don't really know what that means, but I do know, I've talked to my female-bodied friends about how it feels on their bodies, and I know how it feels in my body. And it's some kind of heart-opening, power, like rooted power. So I liken it to the name really being like Aphrodite, and it's like channeling that goddess energy. And I know people who enjoy this just on its own. And then you can smoke flowers, which a lot of us already know. You can smoke flowers because one flower we all smoke and love is cannabis. Now, this isn't THC weed, this is hemp. This is almost non-detectable amounts of THC and high CBD content. And you're still getting the anti-anxiety and maybe the pain-killing and the calming, relaxing, and other things that CBD is supposedly good for, but you're not having the THC. And for me, I don't like to get too high, and dosage is key. So I'll put maybe just a tiny little amount of something with THC in it, and then I'll fill the rest in with these other plants that'll have maybe anti-anxiety or bronchodilating, or they taste really nice. And one of the things I think think tastes really nice is chamomile flowers. And so I've got these little chamomile flowers, and you notice that it's actually still on the flower stem, and that's called the calyx. So you want to just kind of roll it between your fingers and break it apart so that the flower falls apart, and then you can take that little calyx and you toss it to the side and you just mix them into your smoke. And it's nice because those little pieces kind of fill in the space in between. Same thing if you're gonna have rose petals, also very nice in your smoke. You know, you want to break it off and break it up into small pieces. People like to smoke lavender. I'm not a huge fan of smoking lavender. It's very harsh, so don't like make a heavy lavender blend. You wanna just put like a few, I'll put like 3 or 4 lavender flowers, which are teeny tiny, in the whole splurf. And I call this thing a splurf. It's an herbal spliff, like I said. And another one, so if you have anything powdered, you put kind of make it all up first and then you sprinkle the powder, and you can even like layer and sandwich things in, but you don't want large clumps of, you know, powder that can not have air pass through it. But if you do have a powder, like, so this is clove. This is organic clove I actually got on a sale table, but I'm like, oh, it's nice and organic, which you always want something like that with powders because you can never trust what powders are. But I feel like, okay, name brand company, it's organic, it's probably just all cloves, says just clove on the thing. And you can just sprinkle this in, tap, 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 and you get that touch of clove that I think it's called eugenol, is the numbing compound that's in there, and it has that flavor, that taste, that clove taste. I also really love Tulsi and all the mint family things. They just add that menthol-y thing. You can have that bright flavor. Another one you can mix in, I keep in like a spice jar. This one is Salvia divinorum. So this one's got a heck of a lot more potency to it. And it has, if you've heard of it, it has a, usually people, most folks who have seen this haven't seen it in just the plant form. They find it in a concentrated extract, condensed back into the herbs. So you'll see it and it'll have 10x or 50x or 100x, and that's like an extract made and then concentrated back into the herb, and you're smoking that, and that will like launch your socks off. But I like to work with these things how they form in nature, and this is what our ancestors in the Central Americas would work with in this form, and have, I don't know their rituals around it, but when I touch a little bit of it into my smoke, it definitely, and I'm in a meditative, introspective place, I keep it for special things. I don't just smoke it for recreation. It really can like have a beautiful, I wouldn't say, you know, you're gonna blast off, you're just gonna like peek through the veil a little. It just turns the color of it. Another fun one that's from South Africa is called Kana. Now Kana, or Scalidium tortuosum, is a serotonin reuptake inhibitor. And so if you add this to, and it was traditionally smoked and it was chewed and it was imbibed in all the different ways. But if you sprinkle some of this into your smoke, it has a serotonin reuptake inhibition, which means the natural serotonin I'm releasing sticks around in my brain a little longer, and I have a euphoria that's a natural euphoria because it's my own serotonin that I already released that's giving me my enjoyment. And this just helps it stick around a little bit longer. So I love to mix that in too. So those are some of my favorite plants for smoking, and I really appreciate you watching, and I'll be blending all these things together. And if you ever want something like this, you can hit me up. And I've also, if you like these tips, leave a tip. Bush Ninja at Venmo and Cash App, bushninjabotanicals@gmail.com. If you have PayPal or you want to email me. Thanks for watching. Hope you loved it. Smoke plants every day. No, I'm just kidding. Don't smoke things every day. But enjoy yourself.